Mr.
Blake, behind you.
What is that on the screen? Just there.
Yes.
Sometimes it's good to revisit the basics.
Yes, go back and revisit all those hard-earned skills that you have forgotten.
Let's get into that
on the Dash Dash Show!
Yes, welcome to this week's Dirt Shed Show with me, Martyn Ashton, and this guy!
Blake Samson. Nice to be back in the show, Martyn.
No. Mate, how are you?
I'm brilliant, Martyn. I'm over the moon. I'm ecstatic.
It's great to have you here. We have got an awesome show. We're going to be looking into revisiting basic skills, which for someone of a career of your length, you've probably forgotten some stuff you didn't even know you could do.
Oh, 100%. And I would say there's tricks, Martyn. Stunts.
Yeah, for you it's tricks, sometimes it's trail riding, who knows. We're going to look at that, going back and getting into those skills you haven't done for a while. But before we do, let's head into this week's news. To the news, and it has been an amazingly action-packed weekend. We had the European Cross Country Championships and the World Cup Downhill Openers in Maribor, Slovenia. I say openers because there was two rounds in one weekend, and Loris Verger was unstoppable in the men, winning both rounds. There was some brilliant riding. Matt Walker was going very well from the UK. He was 4 seconds back from Verger in the first round, but only 0.4 back in the second round. He was slipping into third place there. Greg Minnaar took a fifth in the first round, so he's on form as usual. Troy Brosnan, Finn Isles, both notable riders in the top five in that second round. But Loris Verger is going into round 3 and 4, which will be over in Lausa in Portugal on November 1st. With that lead, fantastic. In the women's, it was a bit more of a mixed bag. Maureen Cabarrú took the win in round 1. Miriam Nicole right behind her, but she was 6 seconds back. Now, interestingly, in the second round, it was a new winner, Nina Hoffman, who was riding really well. She just nudged out Maureen Cabarrú. So the form of Maureen was there, but Miriam Nicole was still 6 seconds back, but this time in fourth place. Tracy Hannah followed Miriam Nicole up in both rounds with a third and a fifth. It's some amazing racing going on. Like I said, it's an absolutely jammed 2020 season where they're fitting it all into the very back end of the year. But it's very interesting to see all these racers suddenly having the chance to nip at each other's toes. But it's a great start for both Maureen Cabarrú and Loris Verger. Some notable absentees from those rounds, though, were Miley Johnsett of Atherton Racing and the newly crowned world champion, Reese Wilson, who both had crashes in training and they were unable to race in Slovenia, which is a real shame. It was great to see all the riders at the races, and obviously everyone wanted to get racing and get in there and get involved, but definitely not the start Reese Wilson would have been wanting in those rainbow jerseys. Bit of a shame there. In the world of XC, it was the European Championships in Monte Tomorrow, and it was back to winning ways for Nino Schurter, who hadn't had the race he'd been hoping for in the World Championships a few weeks back, but he was fantastic in this race. He timed his attack right near the end of the race on a descent and just pulled away from Titouan Corro, who was 9 seconds back by the finish line, but a great win for Nino and another European Championships. Over in the women's, it was a bit more standard. Yes, it was Pauline Ferrand-Prevot who took another win. So she takes the European Championships and the World Championships in 2020. Fantastic job. Now to cycling industry news. The 2020 edition of Eurobike, which is obviously one of the biggest trade shows in the world, it had been scheduled for 24th to the 26th of November. That has now been cancelled due to COVID restrictions. The organisers over at Friedrichshafen have taken a look at it and thought, no, we can't do it. So they will be announcing new dates for the 2021 event. In due course, real shame because it's a very big event. It's a big part of the cycling industry's chance to touch base and see what everyone else is doing. And it's a great place for us to go and see all of the tech. So that is a real shame. Now, let me finish by mentioning hashtag trash off. Now, don't worry, it's not an insult. Trash off is a social media project organized by our friends Muckoff and also other friends of ours, Trash Free Trails, an environmental non-profit organization aimed at keeping our trails free of trash. A little bit, does what it says on the tin. Now, how can you help? Well, the trash off is something where you can help. What you can do, head over to your local trail, take photos of any of the litter you see on the trail, give us a picture before and after you've cleared up the trash yourself. And then you can share that on social media, remembering to use the hashtag trashfreetrails, hashtag trashoff, and also make sure you copy in at Muckoff and at trashfreetrails. Then tag a couple of your mates and see if they can keep the ball rolling. The aim is to keep our trails free of trash. You can't go wrong. Now the date, 26th of October, that's when you can post your photos on social media so we get a bit of a good vibe going. So you've got the rest of this week and some of the weekend to get it going. Now go out there, go forth and clean up those trails. Now over in the GMBN shop to finish the news off, have you noticed my nice new top? Yeah? Technical material. This is our new technical t-shirts. I've got the long sleeve on, but we've also got it in this nice short sleeve version. Head over to the GMBN shop to get your hands on our very first GMBN tech mountain bike clothing. The material is fantastic, very breathable, and I'm going to be going out for a push in my wheelchair in this one in just moments. So if you want to support the channel, head over to the shop. Now, back to those two guys. Wow, it's all happening.
It is. But you know what you said right at the beginning of the show? Some of the skills that we've forgotten, like long gone. Like I'm a stunt rider. I've done a lot of stunts and some big ones. And I've pretty much kind of forgotten some of the skills on how to do some of those big tricks. But you know what I did? I headed out to the woods and I thought I would restoke that fire and bring some back to life. So I did it. Windhill, yes, a place where I come to ride constantly, but I don't really session the step up right here. And I'm gonna start off small and maybe end on something a little bit more spicy. First, let's do a few test runs, get warmed up, new bike, jump that hasn't been jumped before by me for a while, and we'll get into it. Okay, before I get carried away, let me put you there. I'm gonna do a whip to warm up. Okay, getting used to the speed into it. It's key to get the right speed. Let's get some arms and legs off the bike. One hand, one foot, both sides. A bit like that, an old trick I used to do on the Animal Bike Tour with Mr. Ashton and Sam Pilgrim. Come to think of it, you need to be that side. It's intimidating to take your feet off your bike, feet or arms, because it feels like you're not in control. Right, that's warming me up. I'm getting there. It's kindling this fire. Humongous no foot, I reckon. No foot or no hand. Let's do no foot first, and then we'll go for a no-hander. Nice. This is a good angle. Right here, and I crash right into you. Hope not. I haven't done yoga, and that was not as wide as I used to do them. Oh, that hurt my hips. Let's do a tuck no hander. Then maybe we can do a suicide. I don't know, I'm still scared. Let's do a tuck no hander. That one's a bit rusty. Took me a while. Right, let's do no foot can. Talk about repetitiveness. If you can't get the trick, you gotta keep going and going and going until you get it. I'm a bit rusty on the no foot can. I feel like my cranks are gonna spin and I'm just gonna misplace my feet. So I'm gonna nail it. I'm gonna do a small one and then I'm just gonna go full ninja on it. I've got it this time. Yes, let's go bigger. Yes, nailed it. Took a while. I reckon, don't know, suicide? I feel like I'm comfortable going like upside down, you know? That fire is roaring right now. The suicide. Oh man. So it feels weird. Doing a trick for the first time after a long time just feels so sketchy, but I'm not sketchy. I'm gonna nail it this go. Watch this. Yes! Yes! Nailed the sui. It's a little bit front high, but you know what? I'm gonna just take it. And I'm gonna celebrate. I'm gonna celebrate with going upside down because I haven't done this trick for ages and my fire is on full pelt. I can't even spray it out with a water gun. Huge backflip coming up. See ya. Upside down, it feels so weird. That one was, got mud in my eye. That was such a pencil flip. I pulled too much. So it sped it up. So I had to like pull out to slow it down. I'm gonna do another one. And this time it's gonna be textbook. That was 100% better. Stoked. Man, it is so good coming back out and doing something that you haven't been doing for ages. Even if it's riding a normal trail, going out there and riding it for the very first time after a while, it's gonna feel intimidating. Hitting a drop for the first time, it's gonna feel very intimidating. Even just going up to it and constantly trying to psych yourself up, but you really wanna do it. Like stunts is what I really love doing. I love doing stunts and I don't do it very often because I'm doing other things, but this has actually kindled my fire and I just wanna keep doing it. Right, back to the shed. See ya.
That was cool, Bingers. It was great to see you out on the trail doing some of those stunts.
It was good fun.
Again,
it was good fun. It makes me want to go back and do some. I just want to go and do it more, Martyn. Really, just want to do it more.
Well, you've still got it. That's for sure. I tell you what, dude. It's one of my favourite times of the week now. It's time to have a look in the bike bin. Oh man, we've got a great one this week. It's from Marcus. I mean, look at this blame shop.
Oh my goodness.
It is horrendous.
How did that pop out of the cylinder? How did that happen?
Well, I mean, listen to this story, right? Okay. Riding down the trail when I heard a snap, assumed it was a stick, so carried on riding. Yeah. Got to the end of the trail and the suspension was sitting and bottomed out, very soft. Right. He got off the bike and bang! The sanction literally blows out the canister, covering him in oil, scaring the life of it out of him because it was so loud. He didn't even know such a thing could happen. You know what? Nor did I.
Nor did I. I didn't think you could blow a shock like that.
I've never seen it, but one thing's for sure, Marcus. It goes in the bike bin. That thing's ruined.
Yeah, chuck that thing in the bin, dude.
I tell you what, I'm starting to really enjoy the bike bin. I mean, I know it's terrible that bits and bikes break, but they do. They do. It happens. Mm-hmm. Let's face it.
It does.
And I like that we're not really focusing on the whys or whos in the breakages. It's just like the experience of. So send us in your broken bits and bikes to our uploader. Put it in the bike bin itself, and we'll take a look. And you might be starring here, even though it was a pretty sad story.
Yeah. Sorry.
Oh, I love it. Right, let's move on to some ways to fix these problems potentially. It's time for hacks and bodges.
Oh, yes.
Brilliant one to start, Blake. You are going to love this one. Take a look at that and tell me, what is it? So clever. Look at it. Just look at it and think, what is that? You're thinking it's nothing. It's nothing.
It looks like a piece of jewellery.
It's not.
Is it not? What is it?
It's a power wash.
Oh, so that would screw onto the end of a hose pipe and the pressure would fire out of that.
Is that not the simplest thing ever? I love that. Wow. I love that because it's a hole in a piece of metal, essentially.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
That is brilliant.
It's from David. His location is at home, and it's his cheap power wash. It's fantastic. Now, he is in the running for this week's Hacks and Bodges. I think that's a hack.
I think that's a hack, man. That's a hack.
And the prize this week, Bing, is we're giving away one of our GMBA mugs. yeah, with the silhouette on it. I really like it.
Oh, Martyn, cool. Now that is nice. You're so generous.
I am, well, I didn't buy it. So that Marcus is in the running. Our next one, what do you think of this? And it's like a homemade e-bike.
That looks like a Radley.
It's a Radley Marley.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Mark's Radley Marley. And what he's done is
Is that a lunchbox? Is that a lunchbox?
I think that might be some of the control unit for his Bafang motor.
I get it. Look at that. It's an e-bike.
He's added a Bafang motor system. That's just like an aftermarket add-on.
Yeah.
So the Raglan Ali cost £1,000.
Yeah.
And then he spent £1,100 on a 52-volt, 100-watt Bafang aftermarket motor.
Blimey.
And he's got himself a pretty sick e-bike there. He said it's so fast, it's unbelievable. And he can charge his computer from that battery as well.
What?
Yeah,
it's like
amazing.
A workstation as well as a cycle station.
I like it a lot.
Okay.
The work involved in that compared to Marcus's power washer. Marcus has still got it.
Yeah.
Now, lastly, this is a bodge, man.
What the hell's going on here?
This is a big bodge from Johnny, okay? So he had to get his lunch. So gross. he needed to get his lunch, his leftover lunch,
right.
His leftovers that he's having for lunch to work. And so he's cut this plastic bottle in half.
What? Yeah.
He's stuffed a bag full of leftovers that looks like a colostomy bag. It looks like someone's colostomy bag. And he's stuffed it into his bike bottle.
What?
And then he's like taped it up so it's become basically a water bottle lunchbox.
That's actually pretty good though. Like if you could make a bespoke.
It's gross.
But the stuff in the contents in that bag looks rather questionable, doesn't it?
It looks so much
that's
like other stuff you wouldn't want to eat. It's a bodge.
Bodge.
It works. The thing is, when you're going to have your lunch, you want to have something that makes you have an appetite, and that whole process has just not given me an appetite in any way.
No. Well, at least he got his lunch to work.
At least he did. It worked. Right, it's Johnny or it's... Mark or it's Marcus, who are you going with, Bing, as you're awarding a GMBN mug?
Do you know what? My simplicity is key. I think David got it.
Simplicity?
I've made a word up, Martyn.
You make lots of words
up. Yeah, I do.
Simplicity.
Simplicity.
Because of his simplicity, Mark, you are a winner. Well done. You have won yourself a GMBN mug. That is awesome. If you'd like to be part of Hacks and Bodges, you've got some amazing ingenuity that you'd like to show us, then please get involved. You could win yourself a GMBN prize. Head over to the uploader and send us something and tell us why you did it.
Please.
Okay, still lots to come on the show. We've got the bike vault, the caption contest, and we've got a Thousand Sends medley. Aww. It's all happening. But I tell you what, before we get going any further, let's have a look at that caption contest, which actually last week wasn't caption contest. We did a What Happened Next.
Yes, Martyn.
Now, Blake, did you see this video?
Did
you get it right?
I did. Do you know what? I don't know if I got it right yet, but what I interpreted was that he just landed on his back and just completely KO'd made the best sound ever. Winded.
Well, yeah, weirdly, there's no sound on it because it's out of a window. I quite like that. But we've had some great suggestions, and the winner is not necessarily what's right, because if you can suggest something that's fantastically funny, that might win too. And again, what should we give away here, Bingus? Maybe a mug again?
I reckon
Should we give away another mug.
It is winter. We've got to keep that soul warm.
All right, let's give away another mug. Man, I could get in trouble because the mugs are sought after. right, it's a mug up for grabs. Here we go. Rock Solid ATA says, what happened next? A cow runs down the street and hits him.
That's a bit outlandish, isn't it?
I like that one.
Oh, I think
I like that one.
What about Carter like W? Says, he said, one more try, and got hit by a bus. It's not a cow, but a bus.
That's a bit dark.
It is a bit dark.
A bus. Pablo Crack said, does a swerve avoiding a car then continues to do a flawless 360 wheelie?
Oh, wow, that is... Imagine that.
That'd be sick. That'd be sick.
Drew Blazer tries to stop it and goes over the bars. Okay, now that one's...
Right.
That looks, sounds yeah, about close. Right.
That's close, and I think Drew has basically got it right. Okay, look at this. Let's see it through. Here
I
we go.
I want to see what happens.
So he comes and he tests a little endo, and then
what?
Look at that!
What
right, so he goes right.
How does he do
it's like
that?
A front flip to feet, mate. If you planned that, you couldn't do it.
No, I don't think I want
no
to
way.
Do it. Plan it. That's quite scary.
It's so weird. It's such a weird way to go over the bars.
Yeah.
To actually have gone right over the bars and basically just walk away.
Nuts. On concrete like that. Tarmac, asphalt, whatever you
it's
call
very
it.
Good.
Black stuff. It's nuts.
So I think technically Drew has won himself a mug.
Yeah.
But wasn't necessarily the funniest. But sometimes that's not the way it goes.
Right.
That's life, man. That's life. Mm-mm. Drew, congratulations.
Well done, Drew.
You are this week's winner. Right, let's do another. Should we do, what do you fancy, Blake? Should we do a caption contest this week or a what happened next? I quite like the what happened next.
I reckon what happened next, Mark. Have you got any?
All right. I've got one.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay.
Right here, this one.
Yep.
Have a look at this video, right? I'm going to cut it very quickly. So here we go. Ryder comes in. Yeah. Right, stop there.
Okay. Well,
he's doing
a bunny hop over a log.
Or is that what happened next? I don't know.
I know what happens next. He hits it, he jumps, his chain snaps, he gets flung, his crutch hits the stem, and he ball rides it out of shot. No one knows what happens after that.
It's not as good as that.
Oh, damn it.
Right, everyone watching, down in the comment section down below, tell me and Blake what happened next in that video, and you could be a winner on the show next week. I can't wait to read your ideas. May the best answer win.
Yeah.
Bingers, should we go in the bike vault?
Please, Martin, I've been waiting this long to get in. Have you got the keys? Have you got the keys?
I'm in. Let's go. Into the bike vault. Let's go. I'm in there. I'm in there already.
Oh.
That is a nice bike to start on.
Oh, my goodness.
This is Tice's... Tyrone 29er.
That's titanium.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
Cool, that is. Whereas, I need the belt. That Martin, I think that's, you know, it's a fully rigid rig, and I've done a video which is coming very soon. I think that's super nice.
Yeah, I like that it's fully rigid.
Yeah.
And I tell you what, I can't believe I'm going to say this.
What is
I
it?
I even like the tail bolts.
Martin! Martin's changed. What's got Martin? That is brilliant.
I feel that I'm growing inside. I feel that I am. It's a very nice bike.
I think it's a super nice. Yeah.
It certainly is. Oh. Right, next up, we've got Zan's Specialized Stump Jumper. This is in Slovenia. And he's out exploring and taking this lovely picture. I like the way that he's mixed the kind of concretes with that very matte concrete colour of the bike.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
He's got a nice Ohlins rear shock, Manitou front forks. If you're thinking that the forks are on backwards, they're not. It's the way they're designed.
Yeah, no, I actually was just looking at that. Okay, hang on a minute. Yeah, that catches you out, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. I think it's nice. I can't really see the bike that well. But.
I'd go one more than that. I think it's super nice. Okay. Yeah, it's lovely.
Super nice, Martin.
I'd look at that for a while.
Ooh,
no problem.
Yeah.
Next up, we have got... Ooh, David's
2020
RSD middle child.
What is a middle child?
I don't know that bike.
I know what a middle child is. My brother.
Dolly was telling me about one of these. Yeah. You've got one?
Yeah, it's called my brother. He's a middle child.
You dummy. This is in Sweetwater Reservoir in San Diego, camping with the family this weekend.
Beautiful.
Sweetwater Country Park.
Beautiful.
About to drop in a Sweetwater Ridge Run. A great 2-mile long flow descent.
Beautiful.
Just below this shot. Very nice.
You know what? I can't fault this much. I'm trying to look at, like, you know, is there some parts on it I don't like or something? I mean,
it's hard to
see what components it's got on it.
And it is hard. It's a bit silhouette, but it is nice, Mark.
Is it more than that, Blake?
Yeah, I think so. Super nice.
Wow. Three in a row.
Wow.
Three in a row.
Oh.
Next up.
My goodness me.
Well, hey, why don't you throw a mountain in the background?
Please, just superimpose that there, but I don't think it is, because I think that is Washington State, Martin.
Oh, that is gorgeous.
Eatonville.
It's a transition Sentinel from Colton.
Wow, that is gorgeous.
There's nothing, I can think of nothing bad to say. I guess I could say it's non-drive side.
It could be a random crazy bike. It's in the grass. I think that's, you know.
It's. But can a non-drive side get super nice? Has that ever happened?
Yeah, it might happen. The photo's incredible.
Blake, I'm going to leave it up to you because you are a very well-rounded, sensible guy. Go for it.
Nice, mate. Super nice.
That's four in a row. This is crazy.
That is crazy.
This has never happened.
Oh,
is Tom's Identity metal? And I'm pretty certain that we've run out of super nices. This is a Surrey in Surrey Hills. Just finished this custom Identity.
Oh, my.
It's not a super nice for me.
It's a great bike.
It's nice.
It's not a super... damn it, Martin. It's nice.
I mean, the mountain in the background in the previous shot and in Surrey, Surrey Hills. It's nice.
Nice.
It's nice bike.
Sorry, Tom. It's nice.
It's a nice bike. Next up, Ollie's Merino Bikes Custom Geometry.
Wales.
This is hot. This is hot. And I like it a lot. Look at the wheelbase on that.
Yeah, Doddy will approve of that mudguard.
Yes, yes. It's nice and high. Yep. Everyone learned at the World Champs this weekend how high you need to have your mudguard. Yep. I think...
Merino bikes are good. Beautiful bikes.
It's super nice.
It is super nice.
Super nice.
Sorry, Tom. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's five super nices. Next up, we've got Radka's dream bike, a titanium hardtail.
That is gorgeous. Look how that top tube flows into this
rear
triangle.
All the way through.
Mm. Oh.
Yeah. That is very deliberate.
Yeah. And all the purple stuff. I think that's super nice, mine.
It's verging on a plus tire, really.
Yeah.
I mean, it's definitely super nice.
Yeah, that's super nice, man.
Those little touches of purple. Oh. That's... Ow, we're out of the bike.
Oh, no.
Martin.
Oh, man.
We're getting so deep into that. Tom, I'm very sorry that your identity... It was beautiful bike.
It just dropped below the mark there. We nearly had a full house.
Has that ever happened?
No, I don't think I.
I don't think it will ever.
Very close. Mm. That was very close. I don't know who put that bike all together. It might have been Claudio, the human algorithm. He did well. He did well. If you've got a fantastic bike, I know it's nice, but is it a super nice? Send it in to the GMBN uploader. This show is nothing without you guys.
It isn't.
So get involved. Now, Blake, it has been fantastic to have you on the show, as always. Thanks for doing those jumps, man. It was great to see you revisiting that
stuff. It was good to go back and, you know, do all those stunts again. I want to do more. Maybe I'll go and visit Sam Pilgrim and Matt Jones or wherever and go do some stunts.
Ooh, that would be nice, mate. We can't wait to see that stuff on the channel. Make sure you guys give us some social love and share this around on your social platforms. Make sure you subscribe to GMBN and make sure you check out all the great videos we've got out this week. But for now, let's leave you with a fail and send medley. All your riding, is it a crash or is it a send? Let's find out. See you next week.
I love you, Martin. Oh.
Oh!